Praise the Lord. Father, we bless your name. We give you the glory and honor and all adoration we have has come. Lord, we pray that you speak to us mightily in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And to every soul that are here, Lord, we pray that you take us to the next level of our glory in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And Lord, both the speaker and the hearer, Lord, make us the beneficiary of your word this morning in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And my God and my Father, Lord, I hide myself under your cross. I soak myself in the blood of Jesus. Father, speak your word expressly to us through me in the name of Jesus. And let your people be blessed today in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Somebody shout, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I am so excited to be here once again. I thank the pastorate for giving me the opportunity to give us the word this morning. And I pray that I will not mislead you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I'm so excited because today will be the first men conference in King's Court Parish. Wow. Is that all you can do? Is that all you can do? For me, I can take that. But for the King of Kings, the I am that I am, the one that was, Shekinah of glory, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega, the lift of our head, the one that lives in heaven and lives in heaven as a Christian, the one that rules the affairs of men, the one that makes everything to be, the one that makes it to be alive, is our comforter, is our giver, is Almighty God, is so mighty. Praise the living Jesus!
Amen.
Amen. Shall we be seated? This year's theme is the new glory. The new glory ahead. But while I was pondering in my heart that, Lord, what do you want us to know about this new glory? And the Lord told me, he said, some of us are already throwing in the towel. That, what is it? Let me just leave it the way it comes and let me just move on with my life, whether it comes or not. But the Lord is telling us this morning, don't wash your net yet.
Amen.
He says, don't wash your net yet. For the glory is ahead.
Amen.
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 Do not wash your net yet. For the glory is ahead. I pray for everyone that is already washing his net, the power of the living Most High will come unto you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And the Lord's glory will come upon you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Can you please join me to open your Bible to the book of Luke. Chapter 5, I read from verse 1. And it came to pass that as the people pressed upon him to hear the word of God, he stood by the lake of Gennesaret and saw two sheep standing by the lake. But the fishermen were gone out of them, and they were washing their nets. They were doing what? They were washing their nets. They have already decided there is no more for us to fish. We have toiled all the night and we have caught nothing. They are already washing their nets. Now the Lord Jesus Christ saw how many boats? Two boats. But he decided to enter into the one that belonged to Simon Peter. Amen. That is favor for labor. He saw two boats, but they enter into what? Just one. Why not the second one? Because it has been designed for him to be blessed. It has been designed that his glory will come. Amen.
Amen.
Brethren, peradventure, you are ready to wash your net. The Lord is saying, stop. Don't wash yet. Don't wash that net yet. Don't quit. Don't quit. The Lord is here to give you the glory because it's still ahead.
I pray the Lord will give unto you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I want us to bow down our head and pray this prayer. Because today is going to be a prophetic day. It's not, I'm not ready to sermonize you. I'm just here to remind you what God is said to do. We're going to bow down our head. We're going to pray. That Lord, may there be in any way that I've been trying to quit. May that be in any way that I've tried to throw in the towel. May that be in any way that I've decided to wash my name. Father, Lord, come into my boat. Come into my boat. Let us pray. Pray this prayer as if you mean it very well. Pray very well. That Lord, come into my boat. Come into my boat this hour. In the name of Jesus, pray this prayer as if you mean it. That Lord, come into my boat. Come into my boat. Lord, I know that you can do it again and again. You have done it before. You can do it again in my life. Father, come into my boat in the name of Jesus. I will not give in the name of Jesus. For in Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Now, what is glory? Glory is a state of high honor gained from great achievements. If you have heard the expression, you are in your glory. Have you ever heard that before? When they say you are in your glory, it shows that you are radiating God's glory. You are carrying God's presence. It shows you are the prime of your greatness. Amen. Tell your neighbor you are the prime of your greatness. It means that you are very happy and proud of yourself because you have reached your big goal. That is where glory is upon you. But there's one important thing that I want us to know. Remember, I told you, today is going to be a prophetic day. And as I prophesied, the Lord is going to back it up in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Said, there is something glory that is ahead of you, is that this is a word of assurance for Christians, which says there is hope for us now till eternity. Colossians 1:27. He said, Christ in us is the what? Is the hope of glory. Amen. For everyone that is in Christ Jesus, there is hope for you. Not just ordinary hope, but hope of what?
Glory.
And I pray nothing will stop it in the name of Jesus. Now, when we look at glory, I think about royalty. Now, look at this picture very well. Thinking of royalty, what do you see? You can see the crown. You see the throne. You see everything around you. There is nothing you can do not to. You will look and look and look. You can see that this person is carrying a glory. And at the same time, he's carrying authority. Amen. That is the Queen of England. Amen. I pray that wherever you go, the glory of the Lord will go with you in the name of Jesus. Because when you say the glory, you don't have any choice than to look at it and behold it. What a glory. Look at the crown. Look at the seat. But I'm here to tell you that that seat that you are seeing, that crown that you are seeing, is so small to the glory that the Lord is going to give unto you. As beautiful as that seat is, it's so small. It's nothing to what God is going to give unto you today. Because the custodian of the glory is with you. Christ in us is the hope of glory. In that book of Luke that we read the other time, I told you that favor for labor, two of the boats, they are already washing their nets. But the Lord Jesus enter into one. That is to tell you that God will have mercy on whom he's going to have mercy on. He's going to have compassion on who he's going to have compassion on. Now, are you that person? Are you that brother? Are you that sister? Will the Lord have compassion on you? Will the Lord have mercy on you? Now, it now depends on you. There is one thing that will not allow the glory to come, whether we like it or not. If you like, pray for nothing tomorrow. There are something in our life that will not allow the glory to come. And the thing is your choice. Choose today whom you will serve. Choose today whom you will serve. You cannot be hot and cold. If you want to be hot, be hot. If you want to be cold, be cold. He said, look, one man, he said, I'm going to spew you out. That's what he said. He said, I will spew you out. It shows that the glory does not belong to those people that are lukewarm. So be ready If you want the new glory to come, to be obvious in your life, you must be out for him. But I mentioned the Lord Jesus Christ has seen the oddness in Peter, and that is why he entered into his boat. He knows that if I invest into this life, it's not going to be a waste. The Lord is looking for that soul, that body, that spirit that will be ready to go out and multiply the kingdom. Don't wash your net yet. Someone told me, he said, I'm not worried to be a pastor's wife. I said, who told you about that? Why are you just bringing yourself down? Is it because of the case of the past? The Lord is here to have mercy upon you. Amen. Hey. Amen?
Amen.
Who told you that you are not worthy? The thing is just for you to be ready for it. It is your choice. It is your choice. The Lord is an investor, and he will never invest on any soul that is not ready. Now, what is your role? What is your role? If you want the new glory to come, number one is that you must be connected to the owner of the glory, Jesus Christ. Your salvation is very important. John 3:3. You cannot enter into that kingdom except you believe in Christ Jesus. You cannot enter there. You cannot take that glory because he's the custodian, he's the owner. Psalm 64:10 said, the righteous shall be glad in the Lord and shall trust in him, and all the upright in heart shall glory. All the upright in the heart shall do what? Glory. Number one thing is for you to be connected to the owner of the glory. Number two is that let the word of God be your guide. Joshua 1:8. Let it be in your mouth. Let the word of God, let it ring in your mouth all the time. For that new glory to come. For that blessing to come. Because you have to be wise. Because glory is meant for the wise. And shame, the opposite of glory, is for the fool. I will not be a fool in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So let the word of God be in your mouth. Let it be in your heart. A pastor was teaching us what. Was it last Sunday or two Sundays ago? That it is what the bird eats that it takes to fly. If it doesn't eat anything at all, it flies with empty stomach. And it cannot fly higher. Amen.
Amen.
But it is when you gather stamina, with the note that he has eaten, you will be able to soar higher. There's a difference between flying and soaring. When you soar higher, it shows that you go beyond and above. When you see the eagle, when you see them on the sky, they are not flying. They are not soaring. They are flying. But when you don't see them again, they soar higher. That is where the eagle goes. And that is where you and I belong. Because we are not ordinary. Don't wash your net yet. Don't zero yourself to nothing. There is a new glory ahead of you. Be connected. Have the word of God inside of you. Now, when you are waiting for the glory of the Lord, you must be expectant. You must be what? Tell your neighbor, be expectant. Be expectant. Don't just say it in the word of mouth, I'm going to my new glory. What are you doing? Be expecting that my glory is going to come. Brethren, the glory is here already. But there is a new glory that the Lord has designed for you and I for 2020. That is the essence of this year's conference. And it is for us to prepare ourselves ahead. There is a task ahead for us. For the new glory to abide. Don't just wash your net yet. 2019. Before the year runs to an end, the Lord can still come into your boat.
Amen.
Somebody saying amen.
Amen.
Those that can say amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. The glory of the latter shall surpass former. It's not just about going to church. I just say I wear my clothes. I go to church. I just fraternize. I just socialize, and I go back home. There must be a change in my life. I will not do it in vain.
Amen.
You will not do it in vain in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be expectant. 2 Kings 7:1-2. That man When Prophet Elijah prophesied, he said, by tomorrow, we are going to be having abundance. But that man that is even closer to the king, he said, would that be possible? Now, what happened to him? When that blessing come, when the abundance come, at the gate, they trampled upon him, and he was dead. He never partake of it. That will not be your portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Be expectant. Don't doubt. Oh, who is that boy? Who is he to talk to us? Why is he on the poop itself? Who has him to go and speak nonsense over there? It's none of your business. Look at this boy. Forget about this boy that is speaking now. Look at the cross. Who gave him the authority to be telling us this? Forget about him. Just look at the cross. So that you don't be like that man. He's so closer to the king. When the blessing come, he was trampled upon. They marched on him to death. He never partake of it. Don't doubt. Be expectant. Another thing is that you must activate your faith. There's a difference between having faith and activating your faith. I know of a sister. They have been waiting upon the Lord for child. And they waited and they waited. And the Lord, there's a word of wisdom. Go and buy the baby things. And she applied. She bought baby things. And she even already named the children that they're going to bear. I can't remember the name now. She gave them names. And every morning they will pray, both husband and wife, they will pray. They will call the name of the baby, this and that, with baby things, and they will go to work. They keep prophesying it. But there's one thing I want you to know. Though it may tarry, but it will surely come. Wait. It may tarry, but it will do what? It will surely come. Lo and behold, they came. The two of them came. They didn't come in one. Two. What people will use for 3 years to have, they have it in just 1 year. Praise the Lord. Then after that, I know of a brother that whenever they talk about if you are looking for fruit of the womb, the wife will not come out, but this brother will come out. Everybody keep looking at the brother. What's going on? He's so expectant. He will just come out. And lo and behold, when they have baby, when he was giving testimony, it's really worth it. He has a low sperm count. And he said, he keep prophesying it. Today, he has 2 girls and 1 boy. Amen. 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 So beautiful children. Are you here? Don't wash your net yet. The new glory is what? It's ahead. Someone, okay, what about the person that never had womb at all? They have taken away his womb away. Oh, scientists will tell me it's impossible. What are you telling me without womb? She gave birth. She was there in the national camp. She gave birth. Praise the Lord. So activate your faith. Hebrews 11:1 talks about, now faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen. For by it, the people of the old received their what? Their commendation. By faith, we understand that the universe was created by the word of God so that what is seen was not made out of things that are visible. Amen.
Amen.
I like that translation. That's why I use that one. So you must activate your faith. Things that were not seen, the Lord made it to be what? To be visible. Brethren, you must have vision. Without vision, you cannot achieve anything. Oh, you want to build a house. Do you have the master plan in your head? You visualize it. If you don't visualize it, you will not get it. If you don't visualize the glory that is ahead of you, you cannot get it. Oh, where do you want to be in the next 5 years? Where do you want to be in the next 2 years? You must visualize it. That is exercising your faith. You must have vision. Our Father in the Lord, the general overseer of this mission, he has a very big vision. And that is why we are here in America. Something that started in one village in Nigeria is all over the world. Somebody shout hallelujah. Activating your faith and having vision will make your new glory to come. And those things that you have been expecting, it will make it to come to pass in your life. So shall it be in the name of Jesus. Now, another thing is this. You must obey. The last one. Because of our time. There must be absolute obedience. Your role to take for the new glory to come. There must be absolute what? Obedience. You must depend. You must rely on God. Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. They said, even if our God will not save us, so be it. Amen. He said, even if it shows that they have assurance, he said, we will not bow for you. Daniel did not take part of the meal. He refused to take part of the meal. He said, no, we will not take part of it. Total obedience. He told Abraham, he said, go to that land that you have not seen before. How many of you just carry your bag? I don't know where I'm going. I'm just going. It might look stupid. But obedience. And that just reminds me one of my teachers in elementary, in primary school. He used to say this word. He said, obedience is the universal duty. He who refuses to bend must break. Then we'll just look at this man. What's he saying? He said, primary schools, 80s. He said, he who refuses to bend must break. If you don't obey right now to learn easily, you will learn hard way. For the new glory to come, you must be ready to listen, to obey. Don't ask questions. That is why I find it very funny in this part of the world. They will ask you why. Why do I have to do it this way? Why do I have even to do it? Why must I leave this place? Why must I sit in that place? You guys are sitting in the big chair. Why am I sitting on a small chair? Children will ask questions. They have reason to tell you. They have 1,001 reasons not to do things. Brethren, I'm here to tell you that obedience is a universal deal. He who refuses to bend must break. We will not break in the name of Jesus. Amen. I say we will not break in the name of Jesus. Now, I want us to look at one thing again. That in a place of prayer like this, we can feel the presence of the Lord. We can see what God is doing in this church. We can also see what the Lord is doing among our men. Men shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you want to clap, clap now. Amen. Amen. Now, when the glory of the Lord comes, it will be obvious for you to see. He said, light cometh and darkness cannot comprehend it. When it comes, nobody can stop it. Even you yourself, you can't stop it. Amen. 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 Because the glory is already around. Because when glory comes, your story will turn to what? Testimony. Amen. Anna has been going to Shiloh for several years. But there comes a point in her life that he went to the Lord. He has been going to that Shiloh all the time. The Lord answered her. And when he came out with her baby, people can see. Testimony that can share itself. It doesn't matter that when she opened her and said, I now have a baby, you can see it. That will be your portion in Jesus' name. Your glory. Your story will change in the name of Jesus. Amen. Don't wash your nets yet. Your glory will come. Amen. Now your enemy will be disappointed. Amen. I remember that story in the book of Esther. Even Aman and Mordecai. The gallows that he has prepared. It's the same gallows. The king asked him, what do you think that we can do for this man? Put him on a horse. Let him ride. Let him enjoy. Okay, what about this one? He said, just put that person in the gallows. The same gallows that he has prepared. The same thing he was buried in. That will be your portion in Jesus' name. The enemy that will prepare a gallows for you, the same gallows they will put your enemy in the name of Jesus. Now, when the glory comes, your labor will turn to what? To favor. Remember, Jesus Christ saw two boats, but he entered to the boat of Simon Peter. That is favor. Tell your neighbor, I am favor. I don't know about you. I remember of a brother. He just, everybody was going. He killed when they want to get a visa. And when everybody, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the man denied them. Denied. And he was like, I won't go to this man. But the person that was watching said, that's your turn. You have to go. He was just praying. He was just speaking in tongue. So when they asked him a question, say, why are you going this and this and that? He said, till today, he doesn't know the answer that he gave to the man. But all he knows is that he said, congratulations, your visa is granted. Praise the Lord. He said till today, he doesn't know how he answered that question. But it was granted. That is favor. Oh, but the person that just said, you speak impeccable English. I will give it to you because of that. Ordinary thing. Praise the Lord. What about the person saying, is this your baby? Oh, so beautiful. I will give it to you. That is favor. What about creating another department because of you? I've been in that position before. They create a department because of you. Because they know that you are the one that can handle it. Say, bro, you are to be there. And you are elevated. You are elevated in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That is favor for labor.
Amen.
When glory comes, you become an envy to your generation.
Amen.
You don't understand very well. So you will become an envy in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And you also be a blessing.
Amen.
There's a difference between God bless me and Father make me a blessing. When you are a blessing, it shows that you are blessing others with what God has given unto you. Your failure becomes victory.
Amen.
Your failure becomes success. There will be a turnaround.
Amen.
You will experience peace around you.
Amen.
When that new glory comes, nothing can stop you.
Amen.
You are unstoppable in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I stand on this altar to declare as I conclude that for everyone that are here, by the reason of this year conference, you will soar higher in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are unstoppable in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Nothing will hinder you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Yesterday, as we are praying, the Lord opened our eyes to one thing. When Elijah and the prophet of Baal, when they were calling upon their God, Elijah was just laughing at them. He said, where is your God? Has your God gone to sleep? He said, except if I'm not a man of God, if I'm a man of God, let fire fall. And before anything, Elijah did what? He repaired the altar. For your new glory to come, what is in your altar that needs to be repaired? As I close, you have to think about it. What is in your altar for you to repair? For the fire to come. Now listen. When that fire fell, it fell upon the wood, fell upon the sacrifice, burned them to ashes, burned the wood to ashes, even the stone and the rock, it burned them into ashes. And listen, guess what? What else? Even the water, it lifts up the water, everything. Whatsoever that is going to be an entrance to your new glory, the fire of God is going to fall now and going to burn them into ashes in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
But you must repair your altar. At the noon, Elijah repaired the altar. Amen.
Amen.
Are you here today? You are expecting new glory. Are you expectant? Are you saying, Lord, I'm not washing my net yet? But there's this particular thing in my life, in my altar that I need to be repaired. Better not bow down your head and pray. That Father, Lord, I want this new glory. I want it. I want it. Like the slang we say, I want it badly. I want it, Lord. Repair my altar. What is it? I know my own. What is in your altar that I need to be repaired? I want this new glory. Father, help me, oh Lord. Help me, oh Lord. I'm not washing my net yet. I want to be drenched in this new glory. Lord, help me. But eventually you are here. You want to give your life to Jesus Christ. You want him in your boat. You want him in your boat. And you want this new glory to radiate upon your life. Why not lift up your hand right now? I will just pray a simple prayer with you. You have been in the past. You have just been languishing in sin. You are just doing it on your own. By strength shall no man prevail. You have been doing it on your own. But now you want to surrender all to Jesus right now. Why not lift up your hand and say, Lord, from today, I want to follow you. From today, I want to follow you. I want the new glory badly. Help me, Jesus. Help me, Jesus. And so, our Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you. We thank you this hour because you have visited us. We pray that we forever remain in this new glory in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
till you take us to glory. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Be thou exalted, Lord. For in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.